Greetings, Earthlings. I asked Hungry Hubby to get my meat grinder attachment for the KitchenAid out of the pantry. So this is what he got. And he says there is no meat grinder attachment. So I grabbed out the last few boxes, and what did I figure out? The meat grinder attachment was in a box that I labeled Roto Shredder. And in the pasta box, the box that I labeled pasta, was a food grinder. And that's my Lyme disease brain. So anyway, this is the meat grinder attachment, and it fits on the machine like so. But I'll show you how to do that in a minute. Well, in a half an hour. This is 4 1/4 pounds. So that I'm going to cut into strips, and I'm going to stick them in the refrigerator or the freezer for a few minutes. Giuliano Hazan, this is his recipe I'm going to be using. It makes a very mild bulk style sausage. It's just got ground pork, salt, pepper, rosemary or any other chopped herb, garlic, and a few drops of white wine, which you don't need if you don't want to. So that's what I'm going to do. And I'll be back after I delete some old videos because there's no room on this. Okay, see you in a minute. Yellow Petey singing to us. Okay, so let's see if you can see that. This doodad is the thingy that the sausage goes in. So you put the meat that you want to grind, or whatever you want to grind, in that hole. And it comes out this big hole. So how's it come out? It's got a worm. Can you see that? This thing? I don't know because I can't see you. Glasses. Okay, so you put this thingy in. Wormy thingy. Until it's seated, and it is. Then you have a choice of this big grinding blade thing or the little one. Now, the little one makes like really pate-ish kind. For sausages, my brother taught me this, my number two little brother. This one is, I think it's 4 millimeter, and maybe it's 2, I don't know, it's the big one, it only has 2. This one is what I'm going to use for sausage, and I might even run it through a second time, which is what my little brother taught me. But first, this is the cutting blade. This will actually cut the meat up so it goes through those little holes. See, you just set it on there until it's seated, and hopefully that's the right side. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter which side. Okay, so where are you? There. And then you put the big plate in. See those little groove things? Man, my arm hurts. You put the big blade in there. Line it up on those groovy things. And then you finger tight. This will keep getting tighter as you use it. If it gets so tight you can't take it off and you're done, here's your tool to, you know, take it off. You don't use that tool to tighten because then you'll never get it off. You'll break the darn thing. Okay. The newer models have this tool as a dual action tool, but mine is old, so it comes with a wooden tamper, and you use that to smoosh down your strips of meat. Some people use cubes, strips are easier. Okay, so do that. There's also, gosh, this is heavy. An attachment that goes on the top of this so you could like stack your meat on it and go faster. But I don't have that attachment. Maybe Hungry, who's listening to us, will get the hint. And never, ever, ever put these in your dishwasher. Okay, so then you stick that in the doodad, your hub, whoops, and jiggle it till it's seated. I'm positive it's seated. So you take your nut thingy and where's the hole? Put it back in. Maybe. Where's the hole? Oh. And tighten it. And tighten it. Okay. Now if you had that little accessory tray, you could just plop it up there and all the meat would go in it. Meanwhile, back at the farm. Oh yeah, get a bowl. I don't like the mixing bowl for that. It's too tall. This one here, the meat will fall in. It'll be great. And then you're going to put it on number two if you're scared. And number four if you're not scared. We'll start out on two so you can see. The whole point of this is keep a steady flow of meat. Best you can. Okay, so I'm going to turn you off and go find the meat, and I'll be back grinding it. Okay, so I got all my meat. What I did was I cut it into big strips. Hopefully they'll fit in the hole. And put them in the freezer for a half hour. They're freezing cold, but they're not really, you know, freezing. Okay, be right back. Okay, this is number two. And that worm will push the meat through, but if it doesn't, don't press hard on this, just press. Can you see that, folks? Huh, earthlings? Now, if we put it on number four, see, it's coarse. Recipe. You want a pound of ground pork. I've got 4 pounds, so I'm going to quadruple this recipe. A teaspoon of salt, a teaspoon of ground black pepper, a teaspoon of your herbage. I'm using a dry herb, Italian mix seasonings, and half a teaspoon of finely chopped garlic. I'm using the Christopher Wrench already ground up garlic, which I probably won't buy again. And 2 tablespoons of white wine. So I used 8 tablespoons. So here's the pepper, salt, herbs, and garlic. Just dunk it in there. And now for the fun part. You can go ahead and put it in your bowl and put the paddle or the meat hook on and mix it up. I'm not going to do that. Where are you? Hey, hon, can you see what they can see in the camera for me, please? So, I think you can see this, but I'm not sure. Hungry's going to check. Yellow, are you having a good time over there? Can you see what I'm doing?
Yeah, you can see it well.
Okay. All right, so mix it up, but don't murder it. Whatever you want, honey, because I'm going to mix this for about another minute. He's going to add some music. I don't know why he's using bluegrass. I would have put on like Italian. Anyway, so mix it all up. And then you have to let it marry. So could you take that off?
Yeah, I don't know how I got that on there.
Whatever it is, it's talking. So mix it all together until you think it's all mixed up. And then cover it with plastic, stick it in the fridge, and let it just, you know, age overnight. So you get a chance. Sorry about this. Got the clunky part of my bracelet. Okay. Can't take it off unless it falls off. Sometimes it does that. Anyway, so that's about it. And after 6 to 8 or overnight, we'll do a test patty and adjust if we have to.
While we're in the
bulk Italian sausage. I don't know what he's playing for you over there. Hon, could you push the button? My hands are full of pig. Thank you. And we'll finish this up. Maybe even tonight, because it's early. Okay. Earthlings. I'm talking to the earthlings, honey. This was wrapped around the worm. That's why it was going so slow. What is it? It was the outside piece of fat. I really should have trimmed it off. It was like 9 miles long. Okay, earthlings. I put my sausage in a baggie. I'm going to let it go 6 to 8 hours minimum, or even overnight, and then we'll do a taste test. When you're done grinding your meat, if you want to make it easy on yourself to clean out the auger, just shove a piece of bread down in there. It could be dry bread, it could be the heel of the bread, it could be something you have stuck in your freezer for the ducks. Doesn't matter, but it helps to clean out the auger. I was panicking because it was coming out slow, so I didn't do that. I just took it over to the sink and stood there and plucked out that ginormously long piece of fat. That was a, honey, what did you call that fat?
Sinew? Kind of like a sinew or tendon sort of thing.
Yeah. The problem with it that I didn't, I didn't notice that is because A, I can't see, and 2, Hungry made me the sharpest knives in the history of the universe. They could slice the lashes off a gnat. Okay, so it's been long enough that we can do a little taste test. What we're going to test is flavor and texture. Maybe we'll run another time through the grinder. And it's all a matter of taste, so. Ooh, pan wasn't hot enough. So I'll let that cook for a minute and I'll be back. Okay, while we're cooking this, just a little bit of information on grinding meat. Make sure the meat's always very, very cold. Keep it cold. If you have to get bowls of ice to stick it in, do that. We'll pop it back in the fridge. Very important that everything stay cold. Also, when you're done, make sure, and before you start, make sure everything's sanitized. You can use whatever you like to sanitize it. Vinegar works great. And then I know that you're probably freaking out because I use a wooden cutting board. However, that gets scrubbed with soap and water, and it also gets sprayed with vinegar. So, anything else? I don't know. So, I'll come back when this is done. Well, Hungry Hubby is my official taste tester. And this was only ground once. I think it's good. What do you think?
Very good. I go good for breakfast.
Scale of 1 to 10?
11.37.
Ooh, okay. Scruffy's nose is twitching, so. No, none for you. Now if he would just do the dishes.